Good morning, faculty members, respected delegates. I'm Dr. Susmit Kafle, third year resident from D.Y. Patil Medical College, Navi Mumbai. Today's my title is Mucormycosis in COVID-19. It's a systemic review of cases reported in D.Y. Patil Hospital in correlation with the comorbidity. Coronavirus disease is caused by the severe acute respiratory syndrome, coronavirus 2. It has been associated with wide range of opportunistic bacterial and the fungal infection. Mucormycosis is a spectrum of invasive fungal infection that is caused by the mucorales, order that belongs to the subphylum Mucormycotina, Rhizopus, Mucor, Rhizomucor, and the Listeria. It has been associated with the wide range of opportunistic bacterial and the fungal infections. These fungi may present in a wide range of multiple clinical syndromes with sinuses, orbital, cerebral, pulmonary and the gastrointestinal involvement. They germinate, forming angio-invasive hyphae that cause infarction of the involved tissue, giving in a dry gangrene appearance. The angio-invasive capability of the organisms that can lead to the direct infiltration to the blood vessels and the thrombosis or emboli thus can present as acute ischemic stroke. Several risk factors are described, including the diabetes mellitus, malignancies, solid and the bone marrow transplantation, iron overload status, steroid mediated or background comorbidities. Other shared risk factors include prolonged hospitalization with or without mechanical ventilators. Diabetes mellitus stand as the strongest risk factors, giving rise to the 36% of patients with the invasive mucormycosis where diabetes in present cases reviewed in 929 cases. While long-term use of corticosteroid have often been associated with several opportunistic fungal infections that includes the aspergillosis and the mucormycosis. Even a short course of corticosteroid has recently been associated with mucormycosis, especially in people with the diabetes mellitus. Aims and objectives. Aims: to know its temporal association in relation to comorbidities and with drugs being used in the COVID-19. Objectives: to analyze the patient characteristics, associated comorbidities, location of mucormycosis, use of corticosteroid, and its outcome in patient with COVID-19. Materials and methods. Patient present with the COVID-19 positive status with comorbidities, COVID-19 positive status with periorbital and facial swelling. Case presentation. Case 1. A 60 years old diabetic male presented with respiratory distress, left orbital pain and swelling, left nasal congestion and discharge, with fever of short duration. RT-PCR from the nasopharyngeal swab for COVID-19 was positive. Here on the axial images, left ethmoidal sinusitis with ill-defined medial wall of the left orbit and hypointense foci are also seen involving the floor of orbit with discontinuity. Case 2. A 40 years old female presented with right orbital pain and swelling for 5 days. Patient had past history of severe COVID pneumonia for which she was hospitalized 3 weeks ago. She was treated with remdesivir, oxygen support, and intravenous methylprednisolone. On axial and coronal images, polypoidal mucosal thickness is seen involving the bilateral maxillary, ethmoid, sphenoid, and the frontal sinuses with smooth expansion of the sinuses. On coronal image, the extracoronal muscles and the retroorbital, it shows T1 hypointense and T2 hyperintense areas with proptosis of the right globe. Case 3. A 51 years old male presented with right sided weakness for 7 days. RT-PCR from the nasopharyngeal swab was positive. Here, the polypoidal mucosal thickening is seen involving the left maxillary, ethmoid, and the frontal sinuses with T2 hypointense areas with it. On coronal section, the few areas of cortical bridge are also seen involving the left breviform plate with suspicious intracranial extension of the lesion. Areas of altered signal intensities appearing as hypointension T1 and hyperintension T2 involving the anterior inferior and the basal frontal region and crossing the midline. Histopathology evaluation of the nasal discharge reveals broad septae like fungi hyphae on QH wet mouth. Case 4. A 45 years male presented with respiratory distress and pain in the abdomen since 1 week. RT-PCR from the nasopharyngeal swab was positive. On axial images, there is circumferential wall thickening of the terminal ileum, ileocecal junction, and the with mild adjacent fat staining. Here on the coronal images, there is circumferential wall thickening of the terminal ileum, ileocecal junction with mild adjacent fat staining. Discussion. Mucormycosis is an opportunistic fungal infection which causes angioinvasive disease, leading to aggressive necrosis and infarction of the involved tissue. Rhino-orbital mucormycosis, it involves the parenchymal sinuses and orbits and may extend into the cerebral parenchyma. Underlying predisposing factors that includes the uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, immunocompromised status, systemic use of corticosteroids, pre-existing respiratory pathology, cancers, and stem cell transplant. Among these, diabetes is one of the most common etiology. Results. In a recent systemic review conducted until 20 August 2021, out of 27 cases, 21 had involvement of the parenchymal sinuses and 4 had extension of infection into the orbital compartment. One with the intracranial extension and one with the extension into the gastrointestinal tract. The findings of 27 suspected mucormycosis cases in people with COVID-19, diabetes mellitus was reported in 70.3 cases, while 88.8 were receiving the corticosteroid. These findings are consistent with the case series of 27 suspected mucormycosis in COVID-19, where the 69% had the diabetes mellitus and more than two-thirds received a corticosteroid. Collectively, these findings have the familiar connection of mucormycosis and the corticosteroid induced in patients with COVID-19. Conclusion. Imaging findings of the mucormycosis includes the mucosal thickening or the opacification of the involved parenchymal sinuses. Majority of the lesions that appears hypointense on T1 and variable to hyperintense on T2 images. Low signal intensity of the fungal elements on T2 weighted images along with the restricted diffusion on the DWI may be seen. Hypertrophy of the nasal terminals with the nasal secretion is seen with the nasal involvement. Post contrast enhancement can be seen in the thickened mucosa and involved tissue. However, the areas of non-enhancing soft tissue may be seen within the affected turbinates or the parenchymal sinuses and is also known as the black turbinate sign. The signs helps in the early detection of the nasal mucormycosis. Thank you.